On a ces sociétés ultra puissantes qui gèrent des droits d'auteur, qu'on appelle les majors, qui continuent à vouloir appliquer le droit d'auteur tel qu'il a été écrit il y a fort longtemps, et qui aujourd'hui, avec de nouveaux moyens technologiques comme Internet, n'est plus applicable.
It dates back to monopolies that date back to the 16th century, actually. The monopolies that were founded as part of censorship to to prevent people from expressing politically dangerous ideas. And this monopoly was called copyright.
Copyright is based on the concept of copies having like an intrinsic value, that one copy of a particular piece of information at a given time can be valued or worth a particular amount of money. I don't think that copies really are that much worth anymore. It's so easy to produce copies of information. You get this like abundance of copies and abundance of information replication everywhere. You can't really charge for that. Given the way citizens appear, or like the way people appear to be interacting with information online, or with their video cassette recorders, or with their mobile phones, I have difficulty seeing how you can enforce a regime, or why it would be practical to enforce a regime that somehow tries to put a value on the copy.
Lately, the copyright industry's lobby has gone from, okay, we have this commercial monopoly, which only affects corporations that are publishing movies and music, to, we have this monopoly, and we have the right to tell everybody what they can and cannot do. And we should have more powers than the police to enforce that. And that's where we draw the line and say, stop, you're a business, you have every right to make money just like every other business, but if you demand that our fundamental civil liberties are being cut back because you can't make money otherwise in a changed technical landscape, then you will have to go out of business, because we are not going to allow that. Our fundamental rights are and will always be more important than your monopolies.
Ça ne veut pas dire qu'il faut supprimer le droit d'auteur, mais ça veut dire qu'il faut se remettre à la table et se dire, mais comment est-ce qu'on doit modifier le droit d'auteur pour qu'il s'adapte à ce nouveau média? Et ce n'est pas en faisant de la répression sur le citoyen qu'on va y arriver. Comme par exemple en France avec la loi Hadopi, c'est vraiment pas un bon moyen. J'ai même l'impression que c'est contre-productif, que quelque part ça révolte le citoyen qui va créer en fait l'effet inverse et qui va le pousser à télécharger encore plus.
In many cases, like, I'm actually very surprised at the extreme, like, extreme innovativity that people seem to find in like creating punishments for people who use internet infrastructure. I feel constantly taken aback by all the like ridiculous lawsuits, like so this Czech Republic case where a 17-year-old, I think he's 17, maybe 19, was sued for the equivalent of like 5 million euros for having embedded links on his to movies on his webpage.
Le droit d'auteur, c'est pas quelque chose qu'on veut abolir, c'est quelque chose qu'on veut conserver, mais c'est quelque chose qu'on veut restreindre, parce qu'on pense que 70 ans après le décès, c'est beaucoup trop long. Donc nous, en Suisse, ce qu'on aimerait, c'est 14 ans après la publication. Donc on conserve un droit d'auteur. 14 ans après la publication, c'est là où la grande partie de l'argent rentre.
What you see online with some services cropping up now, like Flutter or Spotify and other types of like commercial flat rate systems, is that instead of having one patron, so you think about like Mozart or Beethoven, they were basically employed by the one rich person who took care of them, and I think we'll see a lot more maybe crowdfunded. So it appears to me as if the culture that is kind of like valuable to society, or the much of the culture that is being generated today already is sponsored or receives money or receives popularity through other means than by the copyright.